so they are not ready by now. Does it mean they've not finished packing their bags by now? Amaka! Chioma! Where are you girls now? Aren't you going today again?
Yes, Mom, we are here!
Please.
We are here, Mom.
Sorry, Mom, for being late.
Yes, Mom, we had a lot to pack.
What do I do? Well, I understand. I love you, my children.
Thank you, Mom.
Please, now that you are going back to school, please, on campus, live like the king's daughters.
Yes, Mom.
Please live exemplary lives.
Yes, Mom.
Do not follow them. Please. You know what it takes for me to bring you up to this level. You know how long it is now that we lost your daddy. So please, I want you to make me proud. And not just only me, even our daddy. So that wherever he is, he will be proud of us. Please, as you go, concentrate on your studies. Make sure you don't do anything else apart from your studies and your fellowship on campus. Especially your fellowship, please. And don't forget,
once a week, covenant fasting day.
Mommy, how can we forget that? You always recite it to us every day of our lives, so we'll not forget.
Mom, we know who we are. We are the king's daughter. Oh. We shall never deviate.
God bless you, my daughters.
Thanks, Mom.
You are the best mom in the whole world. God will bless you for us. Oh.
I love you, my girls. Where are your things? Where are your bags?
We are here, Mom.
Let's go. We are running late. Let's go.
Wow. I'm happy for this program.
Wonders shall happen.
It's like this program is for me.
But God must do something in this place.
Must do something, oh.
I will not come in.
He must do something. Because my condition must change.
In fact, I'm believing God.
Must change, oh.
In Jesus' name.
We have come.
They are even
happy. You're welcome.
Oh. How are you?
You're welcome.
Oh, sister, how are you?
You're welcome, you're welcome. She's keeping her.
She's supposed to have been here.
Yeah. At the time.
Has she forgot?
I beg, let her try and come more. He's running late.
She better hurry up. I don't have time.
My sisters. I am sorry, my sisters. Thank you.
You're welcome, ma'am.
You're welcome, ma'am.
Thank you. I am sorry, my sisters, for being late. Actually, I've been on the phone to make sure our sister, our precious sister Abigail, joins us in this meeting. As we all know, she's a very busy woman and has less time for activities like this. Have you done the opening prayers?
No. We still should wait a little longer for you to come.
Okay. Thank you, my sisters. As we all know, that we've been waiting for a day like this, when our precious sister Abigail joins us in this meeting as our special guest. Oh, yes, she comes. You're welcome. Please have your seats.
You're welcome, sister.
I'm so sorry, my sisters. I should have been here 10 minutes ago. I was held up in the traffic. Honestly, I don't like coming late to appointments, especially when it has to do with Christian gathering. So sorry, eh? God bless you. Thank you.
It's okay. It's just 10 minutes late. Let's get started. Sister Ngozi, please lead us in the opening prayer.
In Jesus' name. Amen. Father, as we start our meeting, Father, start with us in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let your spirit abide with us in Jesus' name. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray it.
Amen.
I believe we all are happy and are glad to be here.
Sir.
And to have our precious sister Abigail here with us. She has been in this present truth. The message of the hour. The end time message for a long time. She has been happily married for many years and has lovely and God-fearing children, so to speak, who are worthy of emulation. She is a Christian and indeed a counselor. Sister Abigail, we are happy to have you here.
Thank you, my beloved sisters. I am blessed and privileged to be in the midst of wonderful king's daughters like you. God bless you. Without wasting too much time, we've got to get started. Today is an interactive seminar. We have to touch some of things that are relating to us as women. Can I start from you, my sister?
Shalom, sisters.
Shalom.
Sister, my problem is my husband. My husband is my problem, oh. My husband does not even take notice of me again. He don't even come close to me, oh. He don't even eat my food, not to talk of sleeping with me. I have prayed, oh. I don't pray. I have prayed. The situation is not changing, oh. I don't know if God is not answering prayer again. That man is my problem.
Next, sister, can I hear from you?
Shalom, sisters.
Shalom.
Sister Abigail, let me start by introducing myself to you.
Yes.
My name is Sister Grace.
Sister Grace.
The problem I have is my boss in the office. She wants me to wear her company products. She wants me to compromise my faith. She wants me to wear those attachments. She wants me to wear those weavons. She wants me to mask my face. You know, all those paintings, which I cannot do. Because if I do it, I go against my faith.
Sure.
She doesn't want to understand. Please, sure. I need you to counsel me. Thank you.
It is well, my sister. Can I hear from you, my sister?
Shalom, sisters.
Shalom.
Thank you, sister. My own problem is that I want to start. I want to start business. Sister Grace's own is even better.
Please, can we know your name?
Okay, sorry, my sister. My name is Sister Helen.
Okay.
Yes.
Sister Helen.
Yeah. Sister Grace Stone is even better. She has a job.
Mm-hmm.
Me, no job, no money. I have prayed and prayed, and I want to start clothing business. I didn't have money. I have asked my husband to give me money for the business. He always saying, after, I will give you. I didn't have money. And I have prayed and prayed and prayed. I don't know whether God is answering prayers.
It is well, my sister. God answers prayers. Can I hear from you, my beloved sister, right there?
Shalom, sisters.
Shalom.
My name is Sister Felicia. My name is Sister Felicia.
Felicia.
Me that my husband gave a capital income. Now I'm doing so well in my business. All of a sudden, no peace in my home. I'm fed up with him. I have tried to make peace with him.
It is so, my sister.
I have prayed.
Sister, thank you.
Still no peace.
The Lord will do something for you. It is so, my sister.
Is jealous of my success.
It is well. The Lord
God will
answer.
Help him.
God will help you. My sister, can I hear from you?
Shalom, my sisters.
Shalom.
My name is Sister Bosse.
Sister Bosse.
I want to know, is it a crime to be a Christian?
At all.
I thought that being a king's daughter will make everything easy for me. Look at me. At this age, no marriage. All my mates that are unbelievers are married with kids. Only poor brothers and rich unbelievers approach for my hand in marriage. And I refuse them all. Of course, I know who I am. But now, nobody comes around me anymore. I have prayed. I have fasted. Still yet, no results. Look at Nkiru of yesterday. I saw her with her husband and her two children driving home from church yesterday. Why is my own different? Tell me why.
Well, he's not different. He's not a passion girl.
It's okay. I think we've had enough. If we continue, we'll not live here today. Please, Sister Abigail, can you share and counsel with us what you've heard our sisters say?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Our God is a faithful God.
Oh, yes.
He is not a partial God. He is indeed the God that answers all prayers.
That's right.
God can do anything, anytime,
anywhere. God can do everything right now.
If you believe,
God can do everything, anytime, anywhere. God can do anything right now.
I'll start with my sister Abiodun. I will just summarize my counsel, and the rest is our right attitude to prayers. And as we pray, there is God that answers. Sister Abiodun, you are indeed a beautiful sister. But I must tell you the truth. Even the way, can you stand up please? The way you are dressed now, you are mismatched. The color on the head is different from the one on the ground. You are even putting on a betrothal pastor, a fellowship. With the way you are dressed, your children even will run away from you. You see, I will tell you the truth. When last did you wash your clothes? Or shave your armpit? Because if not that these sisters here have the Holy Ghost in them, they too will run away from you. But I thank God for Jesus. My dear, when you get home from today, wash your hair very well, wash your clothes, even if this is the only one you have, keep them clean always. Make sure your clothes are clean. Shave your armpit, put on a roll-on, so that when people come around you, even your husband, he will be happy to stay near you. You know men are moved by what they see. So my sister, make sure you dress properly. Put on the correct colors, rhyme the colors well, so that you don't look shabbily. God bless you. Ah, my beloved sister Grace. The Lord says that he is the husband to the widows. He cannot leave you.
Amen.
As king's daughter, you have to choose the type of job you go into. As you're already inside the company, before they introduced the ribbon and the earrings, my candid advice to you is to start looking for a job. But prayerfully, try to be cajoling as your boss, madam, like as you said it, is your boss, madam. Just take it easy with her. Don't be rude with her. Because through your attitude, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 7, she might turn to the Lord and drop all those. But if you persist and it's about to affect your faith, my dear, run away. As you leave that job, the Lord, Jesus Christ, who is the husband to the widow, will not leave you to go hungry with your children.
Amen.
He is a faithful God.
Yes.
And he will answer you in due course.
Amen.
My beloved sister Ngozi, the Bible says you should not despise the days of little beginning. There is something in your hand you have, and that is your idea. You have to make use of that. Prayerfully ask God. You might be thinking of clothing business, but the Lord wants you to do another. Have you prayed and asked God, what really does he want you to do? After that, you will start with whatever you have. With faith. Peradventure, your husband is waiting to see your capability before he can invest in what you are doing. I tell you, our husband, your husband, is a nice man. He's waiting to see you move. Then he can invest. Praise the Lord.
Thank you very much.
My sister Felicia, my business tycoon. Successful sister indeed.
Thank you, ma.
Your husband loves you so much. He is the best thing that has ever happened to you.
Okay, ma.
For him to bring out money and invest and give you to start business in this time of recession in Nigeria, he is a wonderful man. And I tell you the truth, my sister. They say power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. This, your husband, can never and will never be jealous of you for your success. He too is a successful man. Before establishing you, he's a successful man. So he can't be jealous of you. He knows you have to help him. But look inward, my sister. Thank God we are all here, sisters. They are not here. I will feel free to talk to you heart to heart. Look inward and make sure that you are not missing it somewhere. Make sure after today's fellowship, as you go home, that you return back to your old love. Prepare the food as at Wendy. Streamline your timing, the time for your business, the time for your home. Check the way you talk to him. Check the way you relate with him. Do you still have time after the business of the day to go to Jerusalem with him in the bedroom? They don't joke with that. Your children too, how do you take care of them? By the time you go back to all this, your husband begin to pamper him. He will know that this is the same lovely woman he had married.
Thank you,
praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I believe the Lord will answer all of you. Just believe and he will do it for you. Praise the Lord.
Please, ma'am. You have not addressed my case.
Oh, my beautiful sister. My beloved sister, Bosse. It is well with you.
Amen.
We are going to rejoice with you soon.
Amen.
He is not a partial God. He gave your sister Nkiru, your mate, husband. He will give you. But I must commend you for turning down the hands of those rich unbelievers in marriage. It shows that you still love Jesus. Because the Bible says you should not be equally yoked with unbelievers, no matter the amount of money they control. But when Jesus brings someone that is not as rich as they are, and you are convinced, go on with him. Build your wealth together, and the Lord will produce an agape modern home from your home. And you will live to enjoy that home. And at last, both of you will make heaven.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I believe the Lord will, as we go home to do what we have heard today, the Lord will answer us in due course. Let us pray. God can do it again and again and again. He's the same God today as he always has been. Yesterday and today and forever the same. There's no reason to doubt. God can do it again. Indeed, our Lord will do it again. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, that we thank you for this short discussion. Lord, they have not tabled this matter to me, but we have presented it to you, O Lord. You have solution to every problem, to every challenge. Father, meet each and every one of them according to their needs, according to their challenges, Lord. That when next they come, they will have every cause to glorify your name. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Let's clap for Jesus. King's daughters, I say, clap your hands for Jesus. You can all have your seats. Thank you, Sister Abigail.
You're welcome.
You know, we know that you will certainly clear our doubts for the delaying of the answering of our prayers. And you have really, really done justice to our hearts. Are you all blessed? Let's share the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely his goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. We are dismissed.
I said you should supply the goods in the warehouse. Please, please, please. Hurry up, the management is on. Hurry up, please. Okay.
Madam, you sent for me.
Yes, Mr. Carver, sit down.
Thank you.
Mr. Carver,
Yes, ma'am.
According to our last discussion, what's your problem? It is because of our friendship. That's why I've been covering up for you. Now, the management have taken note of all these things. You refuse to put on this attach and makeups. Let me be so careful. What's your problem? Now, they've even given me a sack letter to give to you. I've been covering up for you all this while. But you refuse to change. So, Ms. Okawa, please, either you comply now or you find your way out of the company. I can no longer cover up for you. Please.
Madam, I actually appreciate all that you have been doing for me. I know that as a friend, you have actually been there for me. But you know that I cannot compromise my faith. I cannot wear those things. I can't put them on. I can't imagine myself putting on earrings, putting on all those makeups on my face, wearing those attachments. Please, I cannot do it.
But you know those are our main products. I'm so careful.
Yes, I do.
Then what is the problem? If you're no longer interested in this job, please, I am. My own job is at stake here, and I can no longer cover up for you.
There's nothing I can do, madam.
Well, that means you leave me with no choice. And to hand over the sack letter, this is your letter, please. So please, I think you will find your way out of the company since you're no longer interested.
Please, can I see the manager?
No, the letter is from him. He doesn't want to see you. So, bye-bye.
Okay. Thank you.
Please come and take your letter. Take your letter.
Thank you, ma. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah El Shaddai. For the time has come for you to prove yourself in my life. Hallelujah. King of kings, Lord of lords. Yes, it looks as if there is no way. But I know you will make a way for me. For those who have put their trust in the Lord, they shall be strong and they shall mount up wings as eagles. I know there is promotion ahead. Thank you, Jesus.
Now, wow, what a faith. She's not even moved. Hey, I think I will follow her to our church one of these days. Oh. There must be something that is keeping this woman, making her so happy, even with the letter. Hey. Now, wow, I think I have to, one of these days, let me go and see that her church. I know what is really the problem.
Come and see what the Lord has done for me. If it were to be mine, I will really pay. Ah, Jesus, the husband of the widow. Ah, I thank you for being there for me all the time. Come and see what the Lord has done for me. Come and see, come and see, come and see. What the Lord has done for me. Come and see what the Lord has done for me. Imakwa no buru di biya ose mu pute mwam.
Mommy, what's happening? Mom, we had, but God will take control.
Mom, don't worry. One of these days, all your sufferings will be over. And I and Amaka shall take good care of you.
Ah, yeah, yeah.
The Lord has just begun a good thing. It is not even what you are thinking. Yes, indeed, I was sacked. But something else has taken over. Hallelujah.
Amen. Ah.
And the way you people are rejoicing is like you to pass your exams.
Yes, tell Mom. Me, oh. God has been so wonderful. I clear all my subjects.
Wow. Mom, indeed. God is so wonderful.
Yes,
I did marvelously in all my papers, though.
in your hand. Is that your result?
No, Mom. It's a letter addressed to you. I found it at the front of the door, so I pick it up.
Addressed to me?
Yes.
It looks like one of the companies I applied, though.
Seriously?
I mean, where I applied. Hey! Okay, Ruo. Hey! Let me see. It's an appointment letter now.
Eh?
Wait. Let me read. I have options now. Look at it, oh. Official car. An apartment.
Hey!
Good morning, sister.
Hey!
Sister, good morning, man. Sister, good morning. What is happening here? Wait. What is happening here? You lost your job. What is happening? You are dancing. Tell me something. Tell me now. Tell me what is happening. I want to know. I want to share. What is this? I want to hear. Tell me.
You heard that I was sacked.
Yes. And I came to just sympathize with you.
I was just rejoicing that I got one small job to replace that one.
Imagine.
But this letter now just arrived.
That's what?
That this one now is 500%.
Bless the Lord! Hey, wonderful! Hey, thank you, God Jesus. Is great. God is marvelous.
Jesus.
Hey, God just surprised my
Jesus.
Sister. Hey, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
you have answered my prayer.
You
wiped away my tears.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are so wonderful. Indeed, you are good. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, what a marvelous God! What a marvelous God! He has done marvelous things for us. What a marvelous God! What a marvelous! He used to do marvelous things for us.
What a important God!
Oh, thank you, Father. Hey, thank you, Jesus. Hey, thank you, Father. You have done it. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Ancient of Kings. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you.
He used to do marvelous things. Hallelujah.
He has done it for me. What my father cannot do. He has done it for me.
I'm happy today. Shalom, you're welcome. Welcome, my sister.
Hey, sister Biafio, can you be this? Hey,
you are in change.
The Lord has done this for me, oh. My sisters, I beg, I am so happy. Do you know that lost love is fully restored in my home.
Amen.
Do you know that my husband cannot stay a second without staying with me? Hey, do you know this prayer meeting? If not for God, though, I will not be here. I have to beg. No, seriously, I have to beg. Seriously, that immediately we share the grace, I will just want to come and meet him before he could allow me to come. Oh, hey, praise God, my sisters. Oh, I am as happy as newly married. Right. Lord, sisters,
yeah.
Shalom to the bride of Christ.
Shalom.
I was really dampened. My spirit was dampened when we were in that meeting, that prayer meeting that day, that counseling time that Sister Abigail was counseling us. Even though I was trying to control myself, because I was asking myself, where would I go from here? With these two teenage daughters of mine, how would I feed them? How would I clothe them? Even house rent, how would I pay? But do you know, my beloved sisters, that I just got another job to replace that job?
Praise God.
Much more better one. My salary is 500% better than that one.
Wow.
Not just only that. Come and see a Lord.
Hey, Jesus.
Then an official cut go.
Right.
Praise the Lord.
Who say God does not answer prayer, my sister?
I'm a testimony, a living example.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Finally, the Lord has done it.
Yes.
Today is indeed a testimony day. I am very, very happy. As you can see.
Hey. Oh.
Brother Raphael has proposed to me.
Hallelujah!
Not only that,
hey,
our family has met, and the wedding days has been feast.
Oh yes,
please, my
God.
Sister, I am very, very happy. Amen. Finally, the Lord has done it for
Amen.
Me.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, sisters.
Hallelujah!
You can't believe it. I have 500,000 naira.
Wow.
To start my business.
Hey.
Oh, yeah.
The Lord has done it again.
He's really a great God.
Now, I am a great woman. This prayer meeting has done a lot for my life. You just join me and praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Yes, so God has done it for me. He has restored love and peace in my home. My husband is now the best in the whole world.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Finally, the Lord has done it. Finally. Finally, the Lord has done it. The Lord has done it, oh, finally,
the Lord has done it, finally,
the Lord has done it,
oh, finally, the Lord has done it, finally,
oh, the Lord has done it, oh,
yeah, finally, the Lord has done it, finally, finally, the Lord has done it, finally,
oh,
finally, the Lord has done it, finally, finally, the Lord has done it, finally.
I need a mara,
the Lord has done it, finally.
I need a puri, mere, nala.
Finally, the Lord has done it, finally.
Finally, the Lord has done it, finally. Finally, the Lord has done it, finally.
Amen. Praise the Lord. The little drama that you just watched now, you know, are common things that women pass through. Single sisters, married sisters, sisters in business, widows, you know, they pass through challenges like this, temptations, trials. And if any one of you is passing through this circumstance that they are passing through, if you had keyed in into this drama, let me tell you, all of you will testify in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, there is nothing prayer cannot do. These sisters, they came together to pray together. And because they prayed together and counseled one another, God answered their prayer. So with that, we come to the end of this drama.